This video is sponsored by Manscaped. Look, I don't hate the guy. I don't. If I saw the guy in public, if I wasn't really shy, I'd probably just ask for a handshake and maybe for a picture. Maybe ask him to sign a napkin, I don't know. There's no reason for me to personally dislike this guy, but at the end of the day, when you're a guy making millions and millions of dollars on a hockey team, you are prone to criticism. You are not immune from this. And as a result, we're talking today about Jonathan Drouin and how exactly things have gone for this guy. Because if you take a look at the production rates and how exactly things have gone down, Jonathan Drouin is producing at the lowest rate in his NHL career since back when he was a consistent AHL guy with the Lightning in 2015-2016. This video is a little bit more of a conversation about Drouin. That's kind of it, you know? Just a conversation. I'm not going to go into deep dives, digest his play, take a look at individual tapes and dissect those. I'm not smart enough to do that. But what I did want to do is just kind of talk about the guy. That's it. Go over some numbers, go over some historical data, and we will proceed from there. Before we go, though, I actually have to wake up a little bit and give a bit of a shout-out to those in the comments of the previous Canadiens video who commented Wild Wings, or Buffalo Wild Wings. If you want a chance to be featured in the next Canadiens video, stick around to the end for that little cue. But today's video is going over Jonathan Drouin, and the reason we're even bringing this up is because yesterday, the Montreal Canadiens ended up losing to the Ottawa Senators 4-0. It was literally the first shutout the Senators have had in like 2 years, which is kind of crazy when you think about it. The last guy to have a shutout for the Senators was Craig Anderson, and that was 2 years ago. So yeah, not really looking all too good for Montreal to go out there and give the Senators a shutout there. The fact that Carey Price was out there allowing, what, 3 goals and 13 shots or whatever? Yeah, that sucks. But it's not even just Carey Price who wasn't playing to his best. There were many Canadiens last night who didn't really play all too well. And one of them, whose name has been popping up all over my timeline, was Jonathan Drouin. A lot of that had to do with a few chances. A few, you know, opportunities once in a while that he would get. Sometimes he's out there with the goalie one-on-one, in tight, and he finds a way to screw it up. Other times you can see that his teammates are willingly just not giving it to him because they don't have confidence in his ability to fire pucks into the goal anymore. This season, Jonathan Drouin is snake-bitten with 2 goals in 42 games played. Sure, he's got 21 assists for 23 total points on the year. That's fine. But is it, though? Because if you take a look at the points per game, 23 divided by 42 is a 0.547 points per game. If you calculate the previous seasons, though, last year he had 15 points in 27 games played. If you do the math on that, that is a 0.55 points per game. He also had 7 points and 10 in the playoffs, so that's very good, a 0.7 points per game in the postseason there. In 2019, 53 points in 81 games played, a 0.65 points per game. In 2018, his first year in Montreal, 46 in 77 games played, a 0.59 points per game. In 2016-17, his last year with the Tampa Bay Lightning, 53 points in 73 games played. That's a total of 0.72 points per game. Wow, that is really good for a guy who's 22 years old at the time, something like that. And then the year before that is actually the last time Drouin has matched the production he is at this year. He had 10 points in 21 games played in the regular season with the Tampa Bay Lightning, so that's just under 0.5 points per game. But there's an outlier there too, because in the postseason with the Lightning, he had 14 points in 17 games played. Remember, the Lightning went to the finals that year, and Drouin was honestly pretty capable in production back when that happened. He was just under a point per game for the Tampa Bay Lightning. The year before that, though, 32 points in 70 games played, his debut year with Tampa. And it's kind of funny, because this season with Montreal, Drouin has legitimately produced the worst set of numbers in this entire sample, aside from 2015-16, where he was at a lower points per game in the regular season, but he came alive in the playoffs. And I don't even want to start a discussion on Mikhail Sergachev. I don't want to go out there, bring up this guy, bring up what he could be to the Canadiens and all that. That's low-hanging fruit right there. Just talking about who exactly the Canadiens have right now, you take a look at Drouin, the way he has been playing, and you ask yourself, is this a $5.5 million player till 2023? Is this a guy you want to keep for this amount of money, and you want to keep this guy in your top six for what exactly it is that he's given out there. Now, sure, Drouin's got himself a nice, grainy, greasy flow, and that ties in very well to our sponsorship for today's video, because support for this YouTube channel is brought to you by Manscaped, the best in men's below-the-waist grooming. Manscaped offers precision-engineered tools for your family jewels and is trusted by over 2 million men worldwide. Join the movement for all your below-the-waist grooming needs. Now, we've collaborated on this because there's some big news in town. Manscaped has just officially launched in Canada. If you're located in the Great White North, you may be one of the first Canadians to experience these life-changing products. You ever have those times? Sometimes it's just a little too much down there, and you need to clean things up. Manscaped is the answer for you with their third-generation redesigned electric trimmer, the Lawnmower 3.0. Cutting-edge ceramic blades, a 90-minute battery, LED lights, and it's waterproof, along with a 7,000 RPM motor and a charging stand. The Manscaped team has created the greatest below-the-belt hair trimmer. So go ahead, trim that junk of yours. Get 20% off and free shipping with the code LEGORocks99 at manscaped.com. Again, that's 20% off and free shipping with code LEGORocks99. Do yourself a favor and check out Manscaped. Okay, you know I had to get that in there. That was a great segue into the little sponsorship. But when it comes to Drouin, it's so crazy to me to see the development and how things have gone down, because remember back in the day when Jonathan Drouin was a Halifax Moosehead back in the QMJHL, he had way more points than Nathan MacKinnon that year in their draft years, and MacKinnon went first overall. Drouin went third. A lot of that had to do with the fact that scouts just saw MacKinnon as the much more dynamic player, and I guess that's worked out very well for him. But Drouin, throughout his ups and downs with the Tampa Bay organization, the willingness and certainty that the Lightning, Steve Yzerman, and co. had that he would develop in the way they wanted him to, wasn't really there, which is why they sent him over to Montreal. And now you have yourselves these inconsistencies presenting themselves in the game today. So much to the point that you watch Drouin and how he is just kind of allergic to scoring this year, and you're like, how the hell did this guy get 18 goals 2 years ago? How the hell is this guy a 20-goal scorer in 70 games in 2016-17? Okay, maybe playing with Stamkos and Kucherov kind of helped, but I mean, you get the point, right? What's going on with Jonathan Drouin here, man? Are we getting to a point now where it's not even about, oh, when's he gonna come back? When's he gonna get those 20 goals again? When is he going to break free and start showing us that he can produce at this level? Is it still a matter of when is he gonna do that? Or is it a matter of, is he even capable of that? Guys can have bad years, yeah, for sure. Guys can have down years, but expectations and reality and all of that, what happened in the bubble last season was almost kind of an indicator of that. Yes, Drouin was out there with under a point per game against Pittsburgh and Philadelphia, but still, the guy was out there with one goal in 10 games played. This season, that goal-scoring drought has carried over. And it's to a point where now, if you take a look at last season, plus the playoffs, plus this year, Drouin has 10 goals in his last 79 games. And you're like, wow, that's kind of similar to what he had in 2018 with the Habs. 77 games played and 13 goals. But the difference was, he was 23 back then. What about now? Is there still a timeline for Jonathan Drouin to come over here and establish himself as that guy who is a legitimate 50-60 consistent point player like everybody in Tampa wanted him to be, like everyone in Tampa thought he was when he was traded over to Montreal that year? He did reproduce a 50-point season in Montreal, yes, but for some reason when I watch this Drouin, it's a different Drouin than the one back then. This one's snake-bitten, he's unlucky to heck, and if he is ever going to find himself in a time to break free and show, yes, he still has that touch to produce, it better be sometime in the next few weeks. I don't want to wait another year to have ourselves what is an ultimate Jonathan Drouin retribution season, because with the way the Canadiens are assembled, this is the year that they have to go for it. The way they made their trades, the way they put everything else up in the timeline, the way they acquired these players, and the way they've organized their roster. You're not going to acquire Eric Staal, who, frankly, hasn't been all too great either, aside from the overtime game, and just sit around and expect to get eliminated in the first round. You guys are going for it this year, Mark Bergevin. This is the year where you need all your players to play at the best level that they're capable of. And quite frankly, I know it's not the case with a lot of the Canadians this season. Deneau, too, that guy. What's going on with Deneau? But Drouin is the one that I wanted to focus on here, mostly because we all kind of know Drouin is like a punching bag at this point. But still, 2 goals in 40 games played. A 4-goal pace on a full season. Sure, playmakers don't get too many goals out there. But still, Nicholas Backstrom, Henrik Sedin, Braden Point, the top playmakers in this league still find ways to score goals. And when you're as unlucky as Drouin has been, things get a lot more frustrating to deal with when you have that going on. So I don't know if there's any antidote or whatever. I don't know what fundamental part of Drouin's game needs to be modified in order to allow him to start producing goals more. Like, come on. He was so close to scoring yesterday, super in tight on Matt Murray, but he just couldn't get it done. That's the kind of thing where you're like, wow, if that was Cole Caulfield there, you think that would have been a goal? Never mind the left-handed, right-handed difference. Nah, if that was Cole Caulfield in tight against Matt Murray, would that have been a goal? I think so. I think Cole Caulfield brings an aspect to this team that we haven't seen in a long time. So, I think he probably gets some time. I don't really know. We'll see. Maybe. I don't know. But for the guys on this team, Drouin, of course, is one of the many players who have not really been performing to their expectations. But because I just wanted to have a conversation about it, I was like, yeah, okay, let's just talk about Drouin. I can't believe we made it 10 minutes here, even with the sponsorship. Man, that sucks. Talk to me in the comments what you think about all this Drouin stuff. Also, if you want a chance to be featured in the next Canadiens video, comment down in the comments section. Zach Fucali, because when I think about Drouin and that Mooseheads team with Nathan MacKinnon, the goaltender, man, Zach Fucali, what a legend that guy was in the Canadiens and the World Juniors organizations and all that stuff. Talk to me in the comments about Drouin, Fucali, if you want to be featured in the next Canadiens video, and any other thoughts you have as well. I hope you enjoyed this video, Trolls 99, and bye.